Welcome to the Great Exodus series. God's plan of rescue for his children. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion. My name is Michael and I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And today, as promised, we will have again the topic of the revelation from heaven of the 17th of July 2019. And I have prepared for you a chart for the timeline that I want to present to you so that you can follow it with your own eyes what the Lord has revealed to me and what I have received through his words and the Holy Spirit. Now, before we start, please subscribe, share, like, click the bell icon and watch all of our videos, not only the Great Exodus series. Follow also the daily prophetic words. And before we go into the timeline, I want to say something about the 17th of July 2019. Many people have said and claimed that nothing has happened. And this is far, so far from the truth. At that day, on the 17th of July, heaven has opened. Many people have seen vision of crosses in the heaven for that special day. And they have felt transformation in their bodies. And some people felt the other side, felt deception and something bad has happened. And I tell you, both camps are right. Because heaven has opened. After a long, long period, now heaven has opened and there's a connection between heaven and earth. And why is that? It is because we are now starting the end times. And the seals will be opened. And darkness will cover the earth more and more. And that is the reason why on that special day, not only the light has come out of heaven, but also darkness. Both were there. Actually, a dual personality had happened in that day. The white and black at the same time. And this came down onto the earth. The blessings, but also the darkness. And now we can start. And I can understand that people thought, oh, this must be the rapture, because the feeling of an open heaven is exactly what we see in Revelation 4:1. The heaven opens and you are called forth. Yes, but that does not mean when heaven opens, you are immediately going. It is very, very soon that people will disappear and vanish from this earth and the escape of the bride will take place, because this must have happened before the seals can be broken. And we are at that time period right now. And I thank the Lord for it that he has opened heaven now. This was a special day. And so many people have missed it. It's because they were only expecting to run away from this world. And they are so fixated on their physical removal that they have not understood the spiritual meaning. And they haven't felt the spirituality that was on this special day. You could feel it. The air was full of energy. And you could really feel that there's something happened in heaven. Have you not? Now, this is what I wanted to say about the day of the 17th of July, 2019. So now, yesterday I explained to you what I received at that day as a revelation from heaven. Now I have made a chart for you, a drawing, so that you can understand it much better. Without any further ado, I will switch over to that drawing now. Hope I can make it. So, I believe we are there now. I hope everybody can see it. Here on top I have written 717 Revelation of Heaven. So, now, it looks like something I have never seen anywhere. And I've never heard a teaching like this from anybody. So let me explain. Here on the left side, here is a starting point. And it starts with the creation, with Genesis. In the book of the Bible, we start also with creation and with Genesis. Then what follows after creation? We are now moving. This is a moving direction. It will end up here. So we start now at creation, Genesis. What is the next? the Garden of Eden, paradise, with Adam and Eve. And then we see Satan in paradise, destroying what the Lord has created by tempting Eve. And then Adam will join in of this temptation. Then afterwards, we have the Old Testament period with the first temple and the second temple, the first temple of Solomon and then the second temple, that where Jesus came in. Then Jesus comes and appears in Jerusalem. This is a timeline, don't forget. Then what do we have after Jesus, after his resurrection and after his ascension to heaven? We have the first Christian assemblies in the book of Acts, right? Yes. And then the next, what follows then closely thereafter, the persecution of the Christians by the Romans. Many people died as martyrs, right? Yes. And then the next, in somewhere 300 AD, around that period, we have the establishment of the Christian faith in Europe, with the establishment of the Catholic Church. Now this is the left timeline, from Genesis over paradise and Jesus towards the Catholic Church. And then we reach a tipping point. A tipping point is the year 1054 AD. And what happened on that day, in that year? In that year happened the Great West and East Schism, the separation of Catholic and Orthodox. And this is the tipping point. Now the timeline will tip to the right side. And now from this tipping point on forward, we are now on the way back. We are now in the book of Revelation. Now this starts the book of Revelation. Because the book of Revelation starts with the seven churches. But why are the seven churches there? They are there to be rebuked. They're there to tell them, please overcome, come out of the old system that we have on this side here and change to a new church. And we see the Orthodox Church, then we see several Reformation and Restoration periods over that time until we reach on 1517 Martin Luther, who is the present time of the Protestant churches. Now, all this we see here. Now, when the church age will be over, and we are right now at this time period, the church age is over, then what will happen? What is written in the book of Revelation, what will happen? It will be the time of the seals, will be famine, and it will be war, and it will be hell and Hades on earth. And this will be the time of the Antichrist. And the Antichrist will be like the Roman Emperor. He will be persecuting the Christians. And he will force his own doctrines onto the world, same as the Romans did. So we see here a complete parallel, only now in the end times, the persecution of the Christians will come. Now, to persecute somebody, there must be somebody there, right? Like here on this side was the first Christian assemblies, came after Jesus. Now we will have a restoration of this kind and way of living. The restoration of the first Christian assemblies in the book of Acts. It's not exactly 100% as they were, but in their spirit. And this will be our societies of the rose, where you come together in love, unity and support. In quasi house churches, where you come together, break bread, have love meals, and everything that also the first Christian have done, to become closer and closer to the Lord. And now you see this time period is exactly a copy or parallel of this time period. We have the persecution of Christians, only not by the Romans now, but by the Antichrist. And then we have Society of the Rose, who are exactly the same as the first Christian assemblies. Now, what happened then next in the book of Revelation, after you see this time period of the seals? Jesus is coming down on Mount Zion. It is the same as Jesus was here in Jerusalem. Now Jesus comes down on Mount Zion. And for his people, now for the people who have come together in love, unity and support to rapture them into paradise, this Jesus coming down on Mount Zion. And only when Jesus comes down on Mount Zion, and only then the third temple, the temple will be built. Now, we have a temple here where Jesus was. So we also have a temple here when Jesus will be there. And this now, when Jesus comes down on Mount Zion, and the temple will be built, this will start the trumpet period, the trumpet judgment. This will start now Jacob's trouble. Because Jesus as a lamb will come down to bring forth the wrath of the lamb from Mount Zion. And the temple will be built. And this starts Jacob's trouble. And then we also see this is a direct parallel to the Old Testament, because Jacob's trouble is about the Jewish children, not anymore about the church, because the church has been raptured to paradise at Mount Zion. Now it's about the Jews, it's about Jacob's trouble. And the temple is there, the temple has to be built so that the temple can here be used by the Antichrist. What then is a clear parallel to the first temple, you see? We have two temples here, two temples here. It is so fantastic, this revelation is so fantastic. Now Jacob's trouble. In halfway of these trumpets, Jesus will go out of Jerusalem and will come away from the temple. And then Satan will come onto earth. He will come onto earth and Antichrist will enter his temple. And there we have the same parallel to Satan on the other side. He was there tempting the people, and now Satan has his time again on earth for 3.5 years. As it is written in the book of Revelation, everything is there. It is a fantastic revelation from heaven, from the Holy Spirit. And what follows after Satan on earth? He will be defeated, and what will start the Millennium Kingdom? What is a clear parallel to paradise? Because this paradise at Mount Zion is not on earth, but this paradise is on earth and was on earth, the Eden. And now we will have another paradise on earth through the Millennium Kingdom with Jesus, not only as our Lord and Savior, but as the King for the whole world. Look the parallels and what happens after the Millennium Kingdom and after Satan was released for a short time. New Jerusalem will come down. And what will happen then? What is written in the book of Revelation? New heaven and new earth. And that is a new creation. A total parallel to Genesis and the creation. Now we have new heaven and new earth. This is the first time that I understand from where the book of Revelation has started and why it has this order. Because it's a true copy of the first side, of the creation side, of this timeline from creation to the Catholic Church, now from the Orthodox Church to the new heaven and new earth. And we have a clear tipping point when everything changed. And there was enough time from here for the church age now. And now we enter the time of the seals, the persecution of Christians, the Antichrist, and the societies of the Rose. The assemblies of love and righteousness, as we had here too. Fantastic revelation. Started here and it will end here. And this is our time period right now, where we are. So get ready, get prepared. You will face the Antichrist if you are not in the escape of the bride. That will still come very, very soon now. Heaven has already opened. The dark forces are ready to take over the world. They are ready to wake up the Antichrist. They are ready and standing by right now. But for this to happen, the bride must go. The one who holds back now must go, must be removed. And that will happen very soon. And then this persecution will take place. the world control of Antichrist will take you. The mark of the beast will take place. And if you're then in the world, you have to accept the mark of the beast, or you cannot buy and sell anything, and then you will die as a murderer. The same as people died here as murderers in the Roman empires. There were also Christians who did not die because they were in hiding and they were outside of the Roman Empire and outside of the access to these bad people. And the same way is here too. The societies of the Rose will be outside of the world and outside of Babylon, and the Antichrist will not have access to them, and people will survive and they will be living at the time of the rapture to paradise at Mount Zion when Jesus comes down to onto his mountain, the mountain that's not carved by human hand, but the mountain that is carved by Jesus. And then the time period of Jacob's trouble will start with the trumpets, the 144,000, the two witnesses. And when we are talking already about the two witnesses, we have a good transfer now to Moses and Elijah, because this time period is the time period of the spirit of Elijah. The restoration, it has already started a little bit here, but now it becomes stronger and stronger. The restoration of the altar, the bringing back of the people to the Father, to Jesus, to the heavenly realm. This is the time period of Elijah. Now, what happened when Elijah was taken away? The same when Elijah's spirit will be raptured into paradise at Mount Zion, what will happen then? The mantle fall. And when the mantle fall, Elisha got a double blessing. And this double blessing in the time of the trumpets are the two witnesses. So, we have here the two witnesses and the 144,000, what is also a double blessing. The disciples, the 12 and the 12 tribes. So you have the 144,000 also in the double blessing. This is all at the time of the temple. Now this is at the time of Elijah's spirit, because Elijah has to come first to restore all things. And this is the time now to restore all things, to come back to the Father, to turn the heart of the children to the Father. This is the time now of Elijah, the Elijah spirit. And he will do that. And he will stand strong against the Antichrist. So now, after you have seen this great timeline, the revelation from heaven on the 17th of July, now I will go to Elijah and Moses, because I received the same clear understanding now why Moses and Elijah were at the Mount of Transfiguration, and why Moses and why Elijah and not anybody else, because there could have been Enoch, there could have been whatever. But it was Moses and Elijah with Jesus. Why? Because these are the spirits that will come back in the end times. These are the spirits that are so important. Why? What did Moses do when he was on earth and in his full capacity? What did he do? He led the Israelites out of Egypt, and he stood firm against the Pharaoh. That was his commission, that was his work, that was his destiny and his purpose. And now his spirit will return, and his spirit will lead us out of the world and will allow us to stay strong against the Antichrist. That is the same what was before, only now against Antichrist, not Pharaoh, but the Pharaoh of this world will be Antichrist now. And we have to come out of the world. This is our Egypt, where we are in bondage and slavery to the world. So the Moses spirit will take us out of the world. And now Elijah? Elijah stood firm against Jezebel, what is the spirit of Babylon. He was against false beliefs and idols. And he restored the altar of the Lord. Fire came from heaven. And now his spirit will take us out of Babylon. The false doctrines, the false understandings, the false churches, the false teachers will remove us from Babylon, because Babylon and the Antichrist will work close together. From Babylon, the false prophet will come, and he will be the sidekick of the Antichrist. So the world and Babylon are working together. But we, through the spirit of Elijah, will come out of Babylon. And we will restore the altar of old, the altar in the book of Acts, the altar that the Lord has given us, Jesus Christ has shown us. And he will restore all things, so that the scripture is fulfilled. When Elijah has come to restore all things, then Jesus, our Lord and Savior, can come back. And he will come back, where? Onto Mount Zion. Everything what is written will be fulfilled. And the end time remnant will move in the spirit of Moses and Elijah. I praise the Lord for this great day of the 17th of July 2019, where everything was laid open, not only for me, but for all of you, that you have a clear understanding where we are now in time and what will happen next, and that the spirit of Moses and Elijah is now down on the earth to fill you and give you understanding and will lead you out of the world, away from the Pharaoh, what is the Antichrist now, and out of the Babylonian false church system, to be completely set free from any bondage and slavery, and now to restore the altar of love, unity and support, and to come together as the first Christian assemblies, where you can see the example in the book of Acts. And then we will gather in the great harvest towards Mount Zion, where Jesus then, after the restoration of all things, will come down onto the earth. Will come down onto the Mount Zion. I'm not saying the earth, because he will not step down on the Mount of Olives. That will come later. He will come down on the Mount, on Mount Zion. However that will be then, I do not know yet, but he will come and his mountain will be there. And then the temple will be built, and then the period of Jacob's trouble will start. But we will be raptured into paradise or sealed as one of the 144,000 to continue. A clear revelation from heaven, a wonderful statement of the power of the Lord and of the laws of the Father. And that's the reason why I said, you want to know what is coming. You have to understand what was before. If you understand what was before, then you know what is coming. This was before, and this one is coming. And we are here now, right now we are here. So, how much evidence do you need that what we are doing in the name of the Father? And we gather you together because you have to be at Mount Zion when Jesus is coming to be raptured into paradise. But before the rapture, an escape of the bride will take place very, very soon. Because heaven has opened. We are now Revelation 4:1 forward. So the escape of the bride will take any second now. It can be taken. And then the Antichrist will start because the restrainer is taken away from this earth. And then the time period of the mark of the beast, war, famine, pestilences, hell and Hades, the seven seals will start. The time now of the spirit of Moses and Elijah here on earth has come. They have come from heaven. Now, you have to decide, because now it's the time of decision. You are as a multitude in the valley of decision right now. Do you want to really stay in the world, be controlled by Antichrist and take the mark? Or if you refuse, you will die of hunger and thirst as a martyr? Or do you want to let the Moses and Elijah spirit come into yourself and come out of the world and out of Babylon and set yourself free and walk towards that holy mountain, Mount Zion, and on the way gather in the great harvest of the ages, and then you will be raptured into paradise? I have always said that there we will have the mansions as promised in John 14:2, There are some Christians who are always mocking this, what I say. And they say, oh, we will not have mansions out of mortar and bricks. Have I ever said that these mansions are out of mortar and bricks? I've never said this. Of course, these are spiritual mansions, because Mount Zion is a spiritual mountain. Where have I ever said these are mansions built like the mansions here on this world? I've never said that. So please stop mocking, you people, because you have no understanding. From everything what I have said and what I have taught you over all these videos, you pick the mansions, the least of all the important things. That only shows me that you have understood nothing. Of course, it's not about brick and mortar mansions. These are spiritual mansions. But you will receive what your dream is about. And if you have dreamt you have a great mansion, you will receive one. But it's a spiritual building, because it's on a spiritual mountain. So people, please stay away from such comments, because they are useless. These people have zero understanding about spiritual issues, and they have zero understanding about the Bible. Maybe they have not even read it. They just want to make comments. And on my page, these comments will be deleted right away. You will not even see them. Anyway. Now you have seen the revelation of heaven, what was given on the 17th of July. Look at it. You can download it. I will put the link in the first pinned comment. And then you can print it out, and then you can look at it and think about it and say, oh yes, everything is parallel. Everything is working perfect. Oh yes, a great revelation from heaven. And also Moses and Elijah's spirit. Yes, it will make sense now why they were at the Mount of Transfiguration, why they were with Jesus, because they are the most important ones, the spirits of the end time. Ah, I thank you that you are here with me. And now I want to return to the other page and want to finish here our great exercise for today. Please download the chart, have a look at it, compare it to the Book of Revelation, pray over it, ask for guidance, and most important, make a decision. Make a decision now, either to stay in the world or come out and be part of Societies of the Rose and be part of Triple Grace and walk that path towards Mount Zion. We have to come together in a great multitude, in the same way as the Israelites moved out of Egypt in a great multitude. Alone in the wilderness, you will not survive. You must come together in love, unity, and support. Share your resources and bring everything together so that we can manage to reach Mount Zion alive and not dead as a martyr. So your decision is not about wealthy or poor. Your decision is about death or life. Think carefully about it. The great multitude is now in the valley of decision, and you have to decide life or death. I for myself have 10 years ago chosen life, and I was obedient to bring all this up. And now I'm rewarded with all this revelation from heaven to tell you, because your time of decision has come. So please decide wisely. Join us. If you have questions, send them to me at triplegrace55@gmail.com. If you're guided by the Holy Spirit, support our mission to the nations. Help us financially, because we are in a financial world. And in a financial world, even if we are separating outside from the world, we need something to survive. We need something to go forward. Wherever we say something, whatever we do, online or wherever, need funds. And you can help us. You can share part of your wealth with us so that we can go and bring these very, very important messages to the nations. I thank you for all your donations. And you find the information how to donate in the description box below. Do not forget that I will make the download link for the PDF in the first pinned comment under this video. And I will also add this video to the playlist of The Great Revelation from the 17th of July. You will find it in our YouTube channel. I am Michael. I am the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. May God bless you and your family abundantly. And I will see you again tomorrow for the next video in the Great Exodus series. Please decide wisely. Maranatha.